Waxing en route superterranean to Toucan Bay via antimatic Congo pump. I met Kane, and he was waiting with the contraband. He had 8 grams of prime Sabaleta X. And while Kane stroked a reefer the size of Mozambique rolled in a roti skin, I held my head wide open for the suck with a nasal oral siphon. And I become so oiled and eager for Joe Sam's return to Houdini's that night that I sped there. Down at a jetty where fish gut funk fumed furiously. And I found copious peoples was already rubbing belly to back and hacking heels. Knee deep in ditch digger nigger sweat. Licking hips with polyrhythmic thunderclaps. Does the butter butt boogie? Do bump hips? Flip and spin and bump and finger pump and sub a quantum bass lines pumping pure people rhythm funk like snake rubber twisting in aluminum bucket. Reverberating round a frolic house with a heavy heartbeat causing black to buck and shipper. Woogie! Woogie! The very groove caused coons to stumble loose and slide on Saturnalian pomade until their conks collapsed. The sound possessed more swing than bachelor galvanizing hurricane, more sting than jab jab whip, more bone than African trumpet bone. It was that pure emotive speed that once improvised homolotic funk to Buddy Bolden's punk jazz on the banks of Lake Pontchartrain. Double bass still reverberating through space-time like long-lost Afronauts and orbiting saxophones. And the solid sound that shook spiritual Baptist shacks with rhythm until the Sankey hymns they sung became cryptic mantras that slid like secrets through water. Charlie, I saw him climb the stairs like a caliper with his clipboard, mop, and megaphone. You see the old bush coolie, he ran the place with the rep and grace of a gambler's tears. Molasses black, with a face like an unfinished wood carving. Tight brown suit, cockroach killer boots. White handle razor behind his ear for peeling more than toe corns. And a voice that suggested a rusty trachea. You see, Charlie liked to grin in that old island pimp style, revealing 10 teeth brown from 55 years of Trini Pepper, chewing Nush and home rolled cigars. But upstairs he ran some severe erotic noir, where the curtains grew dank and butter greased, and where the room smelled like dried pussy, and where cum-crusted face rags lay under the beds, and where his ladies charged by the pound. Your weight plus theirs in cash. Charlie liked to hum as he shoved spum from teledildonic boots, and he liked to wipe his prose down with paraffin. Prime prose with lineage to ancient Airy. Some pork-legged jammets and some melon-swallowing domestic cleaner types with the most devious profiles. Big bone data mamas whose hips retune bed springs to the B flat of colonial brothels. And some wore names like Yvette and Rose and Daphne Gemma. And there was one, you know, I think her name was Janet. And she had just arrived on Kulusupia from some floating island behind God's back. And she would even let you lick her mastectomy scar. Crustacea in the Kilgore Desert, circumpolar roaming with genetic contraband, and he's sure to come back head hard with nigger knots, with a calabash full of manjack bitumen between elbows. And soon as the shuttle land, Kunu people, they go run down from the rainforest to scope Joe in flesh. Cause all them so know that Joe Sam don't eat nice. He don't eat nice. Joe Sam don't eat nice, you know. Hey, now when I tell you Joe Sam don't eat nice, you know. He don't eat nice.